The National Maritime Council also denying the exit of the BRP Teresa Magbanua from Escoda Shoal was a withdrawal. NMC spokesperson Alexander Lopez says the pullout was not negotiated with China during recent bilateral talks. He adds Manila is seeking the assistance of allies such as the U.S. and Japan for what he calls technical coverage of Escoda Shoal and the rest of the West Philippine Sea.
Alam ng mga kababayan natin, maliit lang yung lugar na isang barko kaya na i-monitor. Pag samasamahin mo yung Caloocan, Navotas, Malabon at Manila, ganun kalaki yung Escoda Shoal. So yung presensya na sinasabi natin, our presence there, not necessarily can be covered by one or two or three ships. So ating modality to have our presence there are yung pagpapadala ng barko, isa lang yan. So meron tayong mga technical capabilities to do that also. So that we can monitor, we can detect any illegal activities being conducted there. And if warranted, we will prevent any.
President Marcos orders the government to curb cases of sexual abuse of children. Our correspondent, Katrina Domingo, now on the line with that story. Kat?
Ron, in a surprising and a rare event, the president shed some tears during a public event here in Makati City. President Ferdinand Marcos Jr. admitted to feeling a deep sense of shame over the prevalence of sexually abused children in the country, making the Philippines the so-called epicenter of child pornography in the world. Marcos Jr. gave that statement after listening to a woman who was, as a child, was locked up in a bar and forced to strip dance to entertain adult men. The president said that he could not help but shed a tear as he tried to relieve the suffering that she went through or that the victim went through, and to think how many other children are continuing to suffer the same fate as she had. In 2022, Ron, a study showed that nearly one in every 100 children in the Philippines, or about 500,000 Filipino children, were trafficked to produce child sexual exploitation material for profit. Marcos Jr. describes the statistics as appalling, and he says that the Philippines cannot allow this to continue. He also notes that is not the majority of victims, and that is not the majority of perpetrators. The president said so far the Philippines has only nabbed a minority of the perpetrators, and that seems to be.
Kat?
If we recall, in half of 2024, there were around 22,000 children who experienced abuse, neglect, and other types of violence in the Philippines. That's according to data from the Interior Department. Now, of the 94 police operations conducted from January to September 2024, the Philippine National Police were only able to rescue 169 victims and arrested 51 suspects. The president says that the Philippines or his administration will not stop until this kind of crime has been solved in the Philippines.
Some netizens remind President Marcos of the government's no gift policy. That's after he attended a private concert of English pop rock band Duran Duran during his 67th birthday Friday. The palace said old friends of the president arranged a concert to surprise him, insisting the party was held at no cost to the government. But this did not sit well with some Filipinos. Former Finance Undersecretary Cielo Magno cited a provision from the Code of Conduct and Ethical Standards for Public Officials, which states a president cannot just accept gifts from friends. Magno also called on the palace to disclose the supposed sponsors of that birthday party. Veteran journalist Inday Espina-Varona also wrote, accepting lavish gifts is a no-no for public servants. She also alluded to the persistently high poverty rate in the country. Under Section 7 of Republic Act 6713, public officials shall not solicit nor accept directly or indirectly any gift, gratuity, favor, entertainment, loan, or anything of monetary value from any person in the course of their official duties.
Over in Cagayan, which is under signal number one due to tropical depression Jenner, strong rains and winds are now being felt. Authorities are also keeping an eye out for the Cagayan River, which rose to 3.8 meters. Over in Nueva Vizcaya, classes from kindergarten to senior high school also canceled due to Jenner. In past days, the southwest monsoon had triggered flooding in the province.